family and friends, you're welcome once again to our YouTube channel, the Papendes YouTube channel. God bless you. Thank you, thank you, thank you all our subscribers and even our viewers. We say a big thank you to you all, our dear family and friends. We say we love you. We really appreciate your support. Thank you all for all that you've been doing for us. And for those that have not subscribed, that have been viewing our videos, we appeal to you, please subscribe and be a part of what God is using us to do in this very platform. As you know, this is a Christian YouTube channel where we discuss about God, we discuss about family, we discuss about our relationship, marriage, we discuss also concerning trade. People, you know, we encourage people for the need for them to learn trade, and also, you know, we encourage as much people as possible that really could not go to school due to one reason or the other to go learn a trade. And also we talk about basketball and sports in general, bringing my basketball friends to also share, you know, how basketball have influenced their life positively, even to our very viewers. God bless you and welcome once again. So for today, you know, we are going to be handling a very common topic that we all are used to talking about. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. You know, this, the word fear, a lot of men of God have tried to define it as a false evidence appearing real, something that is not really real, but is there, because we see people are just, at times they are afraid for nothing. They are just afraid. And I will be, you know, discussing all that in these very few minutes that we are going to be having. Yeah, but before we go into details, let us see what fear can do to a man. What fear can do to a man. In the Bible, in the book of Job chapter 3 verse 25, Job chapter 3 verse 25, the word of God made us understand concerning the man Job, a man that feared God, a man that eschewed evil, a man that is upright, a man that we will say was a righteous man. What did the Bible say concerning him? Job was speaking, he said, the thing that I fear most has happened. The thing that I fear most. Meaning, while Job was living a righteous life, while Job was living a godly life, while Job was having the fear of God at every given point in time in his life, raising up his children in the fear and the ways of the Lord, he had this fear that this thing will come upon him one day, or this thing might come. This is how some people are. You are pregnant and you'll be having the fear that, oh, this pregnancy can go. A miscarriage can happen. Or you are married and you are afraid that, this marriage, it might not work. After all, the marriage of my mother did not work. The marriage of my sister did not work. The marriage of my... And this fear will just be there. Even concerning the place where you are working, you are just afraid. You are afraid for nothing. Something wrong might happen. And this was what happened to Job in the Bible. Job was so afraid. Afraid that whenever the children had a feast, a birthday party, or they go out, it will come out and begin to offer sacrifice to God to appease God's heart without even knowing what has happened. But this fear was just there. I might lose my wealth, I might lose my children. And what happened to Job before that declaration or the confession that he made in the verse 25 of Job chapter 3? What happened? Job lost everything. Job lost his wealth. The children died at the same day. His business, everything. He lost his health. The only thing that was remaining for Job was just his wife. And even the wife that was remaining even told Job that, curse God and die. So I would just say Job eventually lost everything. Job lost everything. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Let us also recognize one thing, that this fear that we are talking about is a spirit. This is why God's word in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 made us to understand that God hasn't given us the spirit of fear. God has not given us the spirit of fear. Don't say, oh, it's my nature. I'm always afraid to do business. I'm always afraid to venture. I'm always afraid, you know, to do something new. That is my way of, beloved of God, it is a spirit, and the spirit is working against you. And that spirit, thank God that God is telling you and I that he is not the one that is responsible of that spirit that is working against you. God hasn't given us the spirit of fear. It is not of God. And why it is not of God, there is a need for us to address it. There is a need for us, you know, to stop the operation of that spirit of fear in our life. Because when you are every now and then you are afraid of a particular thing, I tell you, before you know it, there will be a manifestation. I have a sister-in-law, a very close one to me, that whenever we are going out and we are to cross a tile road in Africa, I don't want to go out with her, because she will be on that road for 20 minutes trying to cross 10 minutes. She's so afraid. I'm like, what's the problem? If children can cross the road, we're told as children, while in primary school, look your right, your left, look your right again, or the left, the right. Let's do what we ought to do and cross. The car will be very far. I tell you, this my sister-in-law, she will refuse to cross the road. She'll be holding my hand back, dragging me back. Oh no, let's not go now, let's wait. But do you know eventually that she died, you know, of motor accident? So we just need to be careful. The devil knows what you are afraid of, and the devil will use it against you. This is why we must conquer that spirit of fear. Don't allow fear to take the better part of you. God hasn't given you of that spirit. It is not of God. The word of God made us to understand, I think in the book of 1 Peter 5, cast our care unto God, for he careth for us. Let us cast all our care unto the living God, for God careth for us. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't live a life where the spirit of fear will get the better part of you. Cast every of your care. Meaning, the things that you're supposed to be afraid of, cast it unto God in accordance to God's word in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7. For he careth for you and he careth for me. There are people that are up to the age of getting married. They have the resources to get married. They have a good job. They have even the person that they want to get married to. But they are just afraid to get married. Cast your care unto God. And this might be, you know, you have seen the marriage of your friends or your relative or your parents. What transpired, it was not something that you are so happy about. And you might say, this might be also be my portion if I get married. Cast your care unto God, for he careth for you. Don't be afraid. People are even afraid of their own shadow. There are people that are afraid of their shadows. There are people that they are afraid of fowl. They are afraid of chicken. Cast all your care unto God. Even you are in ministry. You want to venture. You want to go out. You want to begin a ministry. You want to start up a ministry of your own. The Holy Spirit is leading you. Cast your care unto God, for he careth for you. Don't be afraid. If God have called you to do something, God have called you to be a minister or to do his work as a minister, don't be afraid. If he has called you, he will back you up. If he has called you, he will back you up. I think I heard this from my father a long time ago, that if he sends you to the market and anything happens to you on your way, he is responsible. He is going to be with you to make sure that, you know, he takes responsibility where he ought to take responsibility of. But if he hasn't asked you to go to the market and you went to the market, whatsoever that you see there, you're going to bear it. So if God have called you in to do something, God have called us, you know, to go into ministry, for instance, please don't be afraid. Cast every of your care Oh, how we are going to save money to do this? Where are we going to save money to do that? Cast your care unto God, for He careth for you. If only we trust God. If only we believe, we have faith in God, because it's actually the opposite of fear. If we have faith in God, you know, there is nothing that we cannot get from Him. Stop being afraid of that situation, that business. Oh, you are abroad. You are thinking that you would never have documents. You will never be able to do this. There is nothing that you cannot do. Let this be the center part of your heart. In as far as God is involved, there is nothing that you cannot do. I love, you know, the word that, you know, guys are, you know, now using on social medias. What God cannot do does not exist. What God cannot do does not exist. I think I'm going to do a talk on that pretty soon. What God cannot do does not exist. He can do all things. Cast your care unto Him. Stop being afraid. Take the bull by the horn. If you want to start a new business, pray about it. Once the Holy Spirit is leading you, go into the business. Go into the business. Even if you fall. If you fall 7 times, you will rise again 7 times. This is the God I will serve. If you don't venture, there might not be success. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to get married. Marriage is a beautiful thing. I tell you the truth. Don't be afraid. Oh, I might not have children. God have declared that none is permitted to be barren in His house. Read the book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 14. It is for you. Even your cattle, your dog, they are not permitted to be barren. Talk less about you. You can never be barren. Don't allow the fear that the devil wants to put in your heart, you know, to have his way. Conquer it and move on. Cast your care unto God. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. This is a word for somebody. I think it's a word of encouragement that God has actually placed in my heart for somebody. If it is not for you, it might be for somebody else. This is why I encourage us, try to share our videos, because it might be for your friend. It might be for your relative. I know the countless people that sent me messages even after watching our videos to tell us, oh, we are blessed by your message. We are blessed by the message of your wife, and you, the message has been a blessing unto us. So please share, and please, as you guys are watching, sharing, liking, also subscribe. Also subscribe. We have a target to reach before the new year, before the year 2021. Join us to reach our targets. We need so many subscribers. At times I wonder, all my friends on Facebook, about going to over 2,000. What are you guys doing? Please subscribe here. Encourage us and be a part of what we are doing. And also leave your comments. And if you have a question, leave it also in the comment section. You have a contribution, leave it there. And if there is a need, always we'll come and do a part two if we find out that we've not been able to address so many questions that are coming. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Peace and love. Don't be afraid. Fear is of the devil. Faith is of God. Have faith in God. God bless you. God bless you. And God bless you. Bye.